Your AI model is as good as your data. But what if your data is not good enough? I found this interesting document describing Lunar Lake, Intel Next CPU. Lunar Lake will have a new NPU, neural processing unit, that can perform up to 48 TOPS. My LLM has no way to know this. This is new data that was not used for training this model. No clue where these 10 TOPS is coming from. My model is probably hallucinating. Now, let's feed this document to the model. Basically, augment the knowledge of the model with all the data in this article. Process the document and use RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation, and ask again. It can now tell that Lunar Lake NPU will have up to 48 TOPS. Pretty impressive. RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation, can run great on any Intel hardware. Check out my other videos on running RAG on Gaudi, on Intel discrete GPUs, and more. But what is RAG? How does it work? Here is my simple explanation in a working Jupyter notebook you can run right away. What we usually do with large language models is to feed them with a query or a prompt, infer the model, and get an answer. This notebook can help you provide the prompt in English, Chinese, or Japanese. Cool, as you can see in the code. By the way, multiple models could be used here, as you can see in the code. All kind of Llama types, Intel Neural Chatbot, 7 billion LLM, and many others. If you'd like to augment the LLM knowledge with any data it was not trained on, a more up-to-date data or private data or any new data, one trick is to just add this data to the prompt. Imagine that I'm asking a question about the Eiffel Tower, and I can add the full Wikipedia page on the Eiffel Tower to the prompt, for example. This new additional data is usually a local document we have. The problem is, it could be in various formats. It could be a PDF file, plain text, HTML, or many other formats. So we need an unstructured loader that could read whatever format we have and convert it to plain text. The great thing about this notebook is that you got the code to deal with many of these options. You can see that we're using the document loaders from LangChain, and we choose which loader to use based on the file's suffix. Problem is that the text could be too large to fit into the prompt. It will contain too much information, and of course, a very long prompt will slow down the inference. So we can split the text into chunks. We're using LangChain, simple text splitter for that. Now, the truth is that we did not feed the LLM model with text. We first break the text into tokens and we convert it to embedding, basically vectors that are inputs to the model. And we can do the same for the additional new data. Now, we have two sets of vectors, the original query vector and the new knowledge stored in a vector store. Before we add any chunk of new information to the prompt, we need to choose the chunk of data that will probably help us most figure out the answer with the highest probability. So we are performing similarity check, and we're looking for the chunk in the vector store that is closest to the query vector. Now we have the chunks stored based on their similarity. And we want to combine the original query with our new additional knowledge. And for that, LangChain has a prompt template, so you can easily combine the two into a new prompt that we can now feed to the LLM. Well, it seems like a long and complex flow, and there are many possible enhancements to this flow, but LangChain make it all easy. And the code in OpenVINO notebooks is really clean and organized, so let's try it out. But before that, two very valuable features of OpenVINO you can find in the code. First one, you can run the models on any device you like. Yes, same code, choose your device of choice. Second, you can compress the weights. This is done using one line of code. See my other video on model compression. Look for OpenVINO notebooks right here, notebooks, installation guide. Choose your operating system, And this is the fastest and safest way to go. Just follow the instructions. Create a new Python environment, clone the notebooks, run the requirements, launch Jupyter. Here are all the notebooks. Look for LLM RAG. Launch the notebook and just follow the steps one by one. I already got everything installed. No need to do it again. If you face issues during installation, make sure you have the latest versions of everything. If I sometimes even take the installation to the command prompt and run them step by step. Lots of selections here. Select the language, English. Select the model, I'll choose Tiny Llama. And here is a cool thing. We can compress the model weights to FP16, INT8, or even INT4. After we run the compression, you can see how the model shrinks in size when you move from FP16 to INT8 or INT4. Choosing the embedding, and for each of the models we're using, we can select the device it will be executed on. I have a CPU and two GPUs, but I'll choose auto and let the runtime choose the optimal device for each of the models. And since I trust the runtime, I'll choose auto for all the models, but you have the flexibility to choose whatever you like. And now we just upload the models one by one, choose which model's version to use. I'll use INT8, and now the fun starts. We import the LangChain components, build a pipeline, and launch it. You can also launch a standalone demo using Gradio, and it's working. RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation, multiple languages, multiple models, compression on any Intel hardware. Try it out. Subscribe. Thank you.